In this video, I will discuss some system of particles problem. This is the first question. A ball of mass 1 kg drops vertically on the floor with a speed of 25 meters per second. It rebounds with an initial velocity of 10 meters per second. What impulse acts on the ball during the contact? Four options are given. You can pause the video and attempt this question. Here is the solution. A ball of mass 1 kg is dropped on the floor, and when it hits the floor, before hitting the floor, the velocity is 25 meters per second, and after hitting the floor, the velocity is reduced to 10 meters per second. So the impulse is change in momentum, which is the final momentum minus the initial momentum. Final momentum is mass into final velocity, that is 10. We are taking the upward direction as positive, and the initial momentum is m into the initial velocity. Initial velocity is minus 25 because it's in the downward direction. So the change in momentum is 35 times the mass, and mass is 1 kg. So it's 35 kg into meter per second, and it's plus 35, so it's upward direction. So the correct option is option B. This is the next question. A particle of mass m is made to move with uniform speed v naught along perimeter of a regular hexagon inscribed in a circle of radius r. The magnitude of impulse applied at each corner of the hexagon is. You can pause the video and attempt this question. So the particle is moving along a hexagon. So in this corner, before turning around, the velocity will be v naught in this direction, and after turning around, the velocity will be v naught in this direction. Since it's a hexagon, the center of the hexagon will make an angle of 60 degrees with these two sides of the hexagon, and this is an equilateral triangle, so this angle is 60. Similarly, this triangle is an equilateral triangle, so this angle is also 60. So this angle is 180 minus 60 plus 60, that is 160 degrees. So the angle between the velocity before and after turning is 60 degrees. So change in momentum is, final momentum is initial momentum. Momentum is a vector quantity. So we are choosing the x-axis towards right and y-axis vertically up. So the final momentum is mv naught, and the x component is v naught cos 60. So cos 60 I cap, and y component is v naught sin 60. So sin 60 j cap. And initial momentum is along I cap, so it's minus mv naught I cap. So mv naught is common, we can take it out, and I cap is cos 60 minus 1, cos 60 is half, and sin 60 is root 3 by 2. To get the magnitude of impulse, we have to take this magnitude of change in momentum. So taking the magnitude of this vector, we get half square plus root 3 by 2 square, that is turning out to be 1. So the change in momentum is, magnitude is mv naught. So magnitude of impulse at the corner is magnitude of change in momentum, that is mv naught, and sin pi by 6 is sin 30, which is half. So option A is mv naught. So the correct option is option E. This is the next question. An impulse I changes the velocity of a particle from v1 to v2. Kinetic energy gained by the particle is. You can pause and attempt this question. So the change in momentum, which is the impulse, is final momentum minus the initial momentum. Momentum is a vector quantity. And the change in kinetic energy is, final kinetic energy is half m v2 square, where v2 is the final velocity, minus the initial kinetic energy. So this is half m v2 square minus v1 square, which can be written as v2 minus v1, the vector dotted with v2 plus v1, the vectors. And me2 v2 minus v1 is the impulse vector. So this can be written as half I dotted with v1 plus v2. So the correct option is option E. This is the next question. A particle of mass 4m, which is at rest, explodes into masses m, m and 2m. Two of the fragments of masses m and 2m are found to move with equal speeds v, each in opposite directions. The total mechanical energy released in the process of explosion is? You can pause and attempt this question. Here is the solution. So initially the mass is 4m, and after explosion the fragments masses are m, 2m and m, and it's been given that m and 2m move with velocities in opposite direction of equal magnitude, and you find the mass of the another small m, and let the velocity be v1. So since there is no external force acting on this system, the momentum is conserved. So initial momentum equal to the final momentum. Initial momentum, initially the mass 4m is at rest, so initial momentum is 0. The final momentum of the system is, will take the direction towards right as positive. So momentum of this one is minus mv, and momentum of 2m mass is 2m into v, and momentum of this mass m is m into v1. So from this we get v1 is minus v. The final kinetic energy is sum of kinetic energy of the all the three masses. So it's half m v square plus half 2m v square and half m v square. So mv square is common. So this gives the final kinetic energy as 2m v square. So the correct option is option B. This is the next question. A shell is fired from a cannon with velocity v meters per second at an angle theta with the horizontal. At the highest point in its path, it explodes into two pieces of equal masses. One of the pieces retraces its path to the cannon, and the speed in meters per second of the other piece immediately after explosion is. You can pause the video and attempt this question. So a shell is fired from the cannon with a velocity v at an angle theta, and at the highest point it explodes into two parts, and one part is tracing back the velocity. So what will be the velocity at this point? So if the direction of the velocity is reversed, then we will retrace back the path. So at the highest point the y component of the velocity is 0, and the x component of the velocity is constant throughout, that is v cos theta. So the highest point, the fragment just retracing its path, its initial velocity should be v cos theta along the negative x direction. I am taking the x direction as towards right. And we have to find the velocity of the other half, and let the velocity be v2. The initial momentum of this shell is mv cos theta I cap. This is in the I cap direction. So the final momentum in the I cap direction is m by 2, and the velocity of this one is minus v cos theta because it's in the negative x direction, I cap, and this one is m by 2 v2 I cap, and we have to find v2. So since the momentum is conserved in the x direction, these two expressions are equal. So from that we get m is common, it can be cancelled, so it's cos theta into v equal to minus half cos theta into v plus v2 by 2. So from this we get v2 as 3 times cos theta into v. So the correct option is option A.